Hello and welcome to the lobby. It's Call of Duty week, so to celebrate, we have strapped Eric Tay with 4 pounds of C4 explosives, and if he sucks at Call of Duty, we're going to blow his ass sky high.
It's a shaped charge, so Jeff and I are going to be safe.
Yeah, we'll be cool. Okay. Yeah, I'm not worried about it.
We might get a little splatter.
No!
We'll have to get like a cleanup crew going, but...
It's what do you call those ones with the ball bearings in the front? Claymore mines. Mm-hmm. That's actually what it is. He's going to be fine, but we're all toast. Yeah. You son
of
a bitch.
So it's to encourage, cheering him on, like giving him some tips, emotional support.
Call of Duty tips.
Like every Call of Duty player
needs. Have you played Call of Duty before?
Aim at the... Shoot. Mm-hmm. Shoot those guys.
Kill 300 people. Doesn't this, really bring home the amount of fucking murder in these games?
I want to say by the end of the campaign, I had killed 950 people or something like that.
Just shy of a grand.
Yeah. Just missed it. I'd gotten the most headshot kills you could get. At some point, these meters that we're showing on screen here actually stop, and you stop getting exo bonuses from them.
Yeah.
They're like, stop! Stop killing people in
exactly.
the head!
Yeah, exactly. Just shoot them somewhere else. Hit them with grenades, for example.
Find
a laptop or two. What are you doing?
That there's someone out there watching who lives in a town of 950 people.
Not anymore.
And that last shot there, just like... Yeah. That's you, Mom. Wow. Jeff Gerstmann from Drive Mom's here.
Hello, hi.
How you doing?
I'm all right.
Did you review this video game?
I reviewed this video game.
What did you give it in terms of stars?
A 4 out of 5 stars.
Why did you take away the star?
That's how it works. Yeah, every game starts all the way at the top and then just gets chipped away. That's exactly how
every game
works.
Immaculate upon conception.
No, I think that this is in a lot of ways the best Call of Duty has been for some time. Hmm. You look at Ghosts, and Ghosts was not a 4-star game. Black Ops 2 was cool, but the multiplayer kind of same type stuff.
Yeah.
This is, I think, some of the most dramatic changes they've made to just the fundamentals. You know, just adding that exosuit. You know, and some people are like, oh yeah, double jumps and butt stomps, whatever. But it's actually a meaningful change. You can do some really cool stuff with your little exosuit, all your side boosts and jumps, and that mobility that it brings, I think, really adds a lot to the game.
Is it still, though, incredibly similar to the old games? Because even I was watching the quick look you guys did, and when you died, it even did the blur out screen.
Yeah.
Blood comes on.
It's still a Call of Duty
game.
Does
it still feel like that, though? Does it change quite a lot?
Totally, yeah. It's the sort of thing where, these changes are going to be really meaningful to people that really already care about Call of Duty or used to and are open to the idea of a new one. Anyone that's written it off already or has gone, okay, I'm done with these things, they're done.
Yeah.
It's not going to change anyone's mind. It is still very much a Call of Duty game. The controls, the feel, all that sort of stuff. Is right there with the franchise since 07. Yeah. But if you're interested in that type of game, I think that the changes they made have been meaningful. It's the sort of thing. It appeals to me the same way Titanfall did. Mm. That kind of player mobility when you're not in the Titan, all the wall running and all that stuff you can do. It the pace of the game is much faster, I feel, than something like Ghosts or something like Black Ops 2, because you can just get up.
Yeah.
And so the fighting ends up taking place on multiple levels. It's you'd have some sniper camping somewhere across the map up high, and you just know that that's the spot and get them. But now it's everyone is just on the rooftops all the time.
Right.
So it actually creates this situation where now you can go low because everyone's looking at kind of mid-height because everyone assumes you're going to jump up there. So some of the lower paths in the maps are a little more interesting now because people are kind of just all over the place.
Is it like that thing in Titanfall, week one, where everyone's kind of learning how to play the game again?
Yeah,
so nobody really knows how to play it at the moment.
Yeah, I would say just add to Jeff's point, it's the movement dynamics have changed this game. It's still a Call of Duty game, but I don't even think people have touched this it's just a surface right now what you can do with all that movement. Last night for the first time it was I'm starting to figure this out, I think. It's kill a dude up top. There's another guy shooting me, backdash off that, come to, I'll be underneath, shot that guy. And people are gonna figure out the movement stuff and And that's when it's going to get interesting. I think right now it's just people are trying to play with COD, but know that they can do the double jumping and be like, oh, right. I want to double jump everywhere.
Yeah,
and then
exactly.
Like, oh, wait, I don't want to really be in the air because I'm getting picked
off. Yeah,
that's
the thing. And they balance that stuff, I think, reasonably well to where when you boost jump, you hang up there for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very easy just to gun people out of the sky. Yeah. And that's pretty satisfying, too.
Do you play any, Chris?
Yeah, I've played a bunch of multiplayer, and I think the comparison to Titanfall and the way that mobility just really changes the feel of the game is totally on point. I would say, yeah, like, last night I was playing, maybe 3 out of every 10 encounters I had, someone used a boost dodge or something like that, so it's not, I agree, it's not, like, totally pervasive.
Hang on, I got a text message, you guys.
Yeah. All right, we'll
Zampella.
Okay, all right,
like,
okay.
Stop talking about that other game.
What?
We invented double jumps first.
But yeah, the pace of it, and what I think the movement for me, the biggest change, is the fact that you can now, because you can dodge out of the way, because you can do back away like that quick, getting out of a firefight alive is much more possible. Like, you can be in an engagement and, like, since it's not going your way, boom, you dash into a door.
Right.
Where previously you'd be like, I'm going to run into this door, and then they, like, catch your calf and you're dead. Mm. Like, you can jet, like, take a second, like, and then there's another moment in your firefight. The actual engagement itself is drawn out, and so there's more tactical stuff that happens there, which, you know, that doesn't happen every time. Someone gets a drop on you, people are still,
not.
Like, head-to-head shooting each other down, whatever.
And then you got the lunatics that pull out the shield. There's one of the XO abilities is like pops up a little shield.
What is this, Counter Strike?
And you're just like, okay, I'm just gonna stand here and stare at you while you play around with your dumbass shield, and as soon as you drop it, you're dead. Like, this is that's how this is going to go.
I'm gonna slowly back away if you come at me thinking you're gonna whack me with it.
This is silly.
I don't know. My friend said, like, he was in a Goliath and someone pulled out the shield and he didn't know what to do against them because he was just like, what do I do now? He's blocking all my
shots. So in that one instance,
I mean, like, there will be some.
That's always been the shield thing, though. It's like a disruptor. It's like,
or if you're with someone else.
Some people, certainly if you're with someone else. But if you pull it out, people are like, wait, what? And in that moment, like, you should pull it out for a second, then pull your gun back out, right?
Yeah.
Like,
grenade.
That's the use of it in the one-on-ones I think Jeff is talking about. But yeah, it's like the first days of any multiplayer shooter going wide, you're seeing all sorts of people trying stuff and failing at it and figuring out what works. And
let's try some stuff and fail right now. Eric Tay,
this is
what the goddamn hell do you have on you?
This
is a single player.
This
sorry.
Is a C4, remember? If I fail.
What is it really?
So this is, Eric, while you jump in, this was provided to us by the folks at Immerse. It's called the Core FX.
I see that.
On his chest. And basically there's like speakers in his chest that like do this like haptic feedback thing, right? Every time he pulls a gun, blah, 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 blah. Right, Eric?
Does it feel like you're getting shot?
No.
It doesn't feel like you're getting shot. It feels like someone's like vibrating stuff against your chest and occasionally with a gun burst like poking you in the chest.
Jeff endorses this.
It's the dumbest shit ever. People have been making these things for decades. They're always the worst.
We had one that was called the butt kicker. You like strap it to the bottom of your desk chair, and it would vibrate really loudly.
I mean, that's more like it used to just be like, here's a chair, a gaming chair selling, and the whole chair would shake. And then it became like dumb vests like this. I am blown away that you were even showing this on this program and didn't just get this in the mail and go, yeah, great, more garbage, and throw it aside with like the crap you stick on the controller sticks.
Hey man, consumers need to know.
Hey
if
man,
they want.
This show has to happen every Tuesday, whether there's shit to put on it or not.
No, I asked them to send me this actually because they reached out to me and they're
God
like,
damn it, Chris.
Hey, do you want to check out this vest? And I was like, that would be fun to show off on the lobby because this is the kind of thing you see like when you're at CES. This is not the kind of thing that we have, like, we don't have a dedicated, like, hardware space. We're, like, headphones and keyboards and stuff
Brand
like...
Is Peter Brand going to get pissed off that we're doing this on
inching in on his hardware territory? No, I think it's, like, we get the chance to show off these weird niche products for gaming stuff, and it's kind of neat. This thing, you, like, plug it into your TV with a little dongle. It's wireless, and I don't know if is Eric's mic picking it up?
Like, probably. Is
it vibrating much at all?
It does. It feels like it's murmuring.
Is it like giving you a nice massage?
Nah, a little bit. I don't know. It's kind of weird.
You're a man who knows about massages.
Apparently.
I've seen you in the Richmond at like
midweek
on a
3 in the morning.
Yeah.
Walking out all red-faced.
Why are you guys...
Listen.
Blowing up your spot
that's
like
when
this? Sorry.
Yeah. That's when Eric is playing Destiny. Let's keep it real.
Yeah.
He has 5 accounts to keep up on.
I play COD now.
Yeah, you prestige over and over and over again. Have you?
I prestiged once.
Okay. What level are you on? Oh, okay, that's one spare. We'll talk about that later.
Come on, get the door.
Before
get some door
I ask
action.
You about what the hell's going on here. Is that a shield?
I have a shield now.
You're the worst.
I'm going to throw it like Captain America. Oh.
Yeah, Captain America didn't throw
it. He's a little bit better at it than you are, but that's fine. That's why he's a captain of America.
For the folks watching this live, sorry, on-demand folks, you can go do one. We're giving away Call of Duty Xbox One on the show right now. So if you go to the link, which will, there you go, tinyurl.com/win-kada. And go to that while we're live, like for the next 40 minutes or so. And yeah, fill in your information. You might win a Call of Duty X-Bone.
You gotta do it.
Empty.
Get that gray Xbox with all sorts of weird stuff on it.
Talk to me about the single player. Jeff, you've obviously completed this, right?
I have, yes. It's fun, you know. It's one of those things where, you know, that one of the big things they've been talking about is Kevin Spacey.
Yeah.
And you know, he plays kind of the heavy in the story.
Is he in it much?
Yeah, they actually, you know, compared to when you see a lot of like celebrities in games, he's in it more than most, and I think the game benefits overall from him being in it. He gives a good, solid performance. A lot of it's in cutscenes and stuff. Like you're not like shooting alongside him or anything like that often.
I'm banking on that.
Yeah, but I think he adds some weight to the story. Also, like it looks like Kevin Spacey. It moves like him. The performance capture stuff I think comes through really well, and you know, especially in pre-rendered cutscenes, like the character model looks. Yo, that looks like Kevin Spacey.
Yeah.
But also, you know, like he gives speeches like you might expect a Kevin Spacey style character to give.
Democracy.
Yeah. And also out of game, all of the intel in the game is basically like his diary.
Right. So is you're
kind of exactly. So you're kind of getting him telling you where his head was at different parts of the campaign.
Right.
Which is interesting. You know, it's you know, say what you will. Like it's a big summer blockbuster, big dumb story. Yeah. You know what happens when PMCs are turned against America or whatever. Like every piece of modern or future military fiction
story,
that
yeah.
exists right now, it's all that story over and over again. So it's one of those. But I think it's well done, and you know, it's a fun 6-hour romp.
Yeah. Same as what you're used to.
It's a romp. Yeah, it's what you're used to.
So then, in terms of like the actual gameplay, is it the same sort of like short missions that are quite bombastic, split up by like vehicles and like weird one-off missions in between them?
Sort of. I think they do better with pacing overall than they've maybe done in the past. And it's you know, they have missions where, you know, for large chunks of them you aren't even necessarily armed. You know, you're out there doing spy business, and you know, you kind of have your vehicle style missions where you're, you know, riding a hover bike or flying some sort of
like the drone fly
thing.
Stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, where you're like, you know, you're piloting a drone, covering a team on the ground and stuff like that. Like, they do the stuff that Call of Duty does, but I think like it's a lot more grounded in terms of like, it's not like here's the C-130 level and you're so far removed from everything that it feels like a one-off thing. Like, it all feels like tightly integrated into the same story and into the kind of the same environments that you're used to running.
Did you enjoy playing as the same character?
Oh yeah,
like you're not like
you don't really
four
jump
different
from
guys or
from guy
like
to
that.
Guy, and that's, you know, that's I think that's fine. I think it works for this story. They don't necessarily need to jump from guy to guy. But I want to say, well, I guess with the, you know, with limited exceptions, Ghosts was pretty much that
was
guy
much
for most of the time. Except for, I guess, the very, very intro. Yeah, it's a solid campaign. You know, there's some stuff, like, I wish that the branching campaign stuff from Black Ops 2 was something that made its way into all the games that followed. And it's, like, disturbing and strange that it didn't. It's just one of those things where when you've got multiple studios working on a game, like, every year it's different for no discernible reason other than other people made this on a different timetable. Like, you know, the reasonings become logistical and not like, here's the game we wanted to make or here's the best game we could make. Instead, it's just like,
here's the game we've been making for 2 years.
Yeah, yeah.
The game,
yeah,
those guys,
exactly.
Been
those guys
years.
Made some cool stuff. Yeah. Like, it reminds me of like how the NCAA football game was always a year behind Madden. You know, it was just like, we're using their old code.
You're going to be pissed off next year then when they release...
Yeah, when Treyarch comes out with one and doesn't have...
So I think it'll be really tough for whatever is next if they don't have this... So basically, like, if they put out a Call of Duty game that doesn't have this level of mobility in it,
yeah,
and this level of speed, I don't want to play it.
Well, like, you were saying that you went back and played
I finished the campaign I finished playing Advanced Warfare and then played some Ghosts. I was like, man, this is slow and boring.
Oof.
By comparison, the ability to kind of boost around, you know, when we get to multiplayer, you'll see, you know, you can really be all over the place. And it's stuff like, you know, you can just jump and boost forward and just jut forward and kind of really get moving. That's fun. It's
fun
to do. Do
you find yourself doing that, like, just for fun in the single-player campaign? Like, one of the criticisms of our review, which was done by Miguel Concepcion, who's a freelancer, was that, like, the campaign doesn't create enough scenarios where you're sort of forced to use it in creative ways, or it doesn't encourage you to use those exo abilities as much as he thought would have.
Yeah, I mean, there are definitely parts of the campaign that are grounded, but also, like, they don't always give you the boost jump. Like, there are whole levels where you are just, instead you have the shield and like overcharge and some of the other abilities. You know, you've got a level where you've got a grappling hook and, you know, so your exo abilities kind of change from mission to mission. Mm-hmm. And the missions are built around that. So I kind of found, like, generally speaking, the missions where you had the boost jump, you had some opportunities to use it.
To use some boost jumps, yeah.
And not as much as you have in the multiplayer. But, you know, it just kind of depends on how you want to play. You can very much just kind of stand behind something and murder everything in your path that way, or you can kind of run up and jump up and be in their midst and take care of it that way.
Watching Eric totally whiff on that melee has reminded me to ask you how you feel about the melee. You really have to be right up next
there
to someone.
There is zero range on that thing this year.
Yeah. But it got to the point where if you were within 5 feet and you clicked in, you just go, lunge in.
So.
It's like leaping murder lunge.
Like, especially in multiplayer, you got so used to that. It was just like whoever clicks first kind of thing.
You know, and that's one of those things that almost feels arbitrary. I'm sure on some level some designer is trying to balance it out and think like, well, because the guns do this, we want the melee range to be this. Mm. Or at least you'd like to believe that that's what they're doing. But
yeah. Because you've got the exo abilities, you can get up close to them so much quicker.
Yeah, and, like, it's just one of those things where you wonder, like, when Treyarch is up next year, is it just going to be like 5 feet? Or 3 feet, or, you know, like what?
It's like a 10 feet.
Yeah, exactly. But they roll a 10-sided die and go like, here's the lunge on the melee, and then flip a coin to decide if there's a perk that extends it even further. Right? I mean, like, that's the stuff that I find really frustrating. Is that, you know, the path to unlock stuff changes because they can.
Yeah.
You know.
Because I want to freshen it up and have it not feel like the same 8 prestiges you did in the last
Call
of Duty. Right,
and you know, this game is the multiplayer class system is very much based on the Black Ops 2 stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that what they did to it is smart. It's a good evolution of it. And I would kind of like to see them stick... I'd kind of like to see them stick with this stuff for a little bit. Instead of just, like, having the next game be, like, whatever, you know?
Yeah.
Like, remove the boost or you know, get back to regular jumps. And
do you think that's where we're at, though? Like, this is the new sort of the dynasty, as it were, for the next couple of years.
I think there was
World War II, and then there was fucking God knows what.
Well, I think, you know, like, we used up World War II
modern
in video games. You know, like,
think about it now. Like, Call of Duty 3 is like what, 2003?
Exactly.
Like,
someone will eventually
return to
World War
II. Yeah.
Like, it definitely will happen someday.
Yeah, like, zombies are kind of on the wane.
Jeez, I hope. Yeah,
but
zombies DLC.
Yeah.
Is there some reference to the zombies in the single player of this game or something?
There's a video in here somewhere that leaked out. I don't know what you do to get it. I think it might be when you play the survival mode up to a certain point you get
right.
it. But I don't care.
Zombies are kind of odd.
Yeah, what about a zombie drone? Think about it.
Andy Bauman's favorite feature in this game is that if you reload your gun and the clip isn't empty, it doesn't go back into the pool.
So it's, you have a choice on how you reload.
Oh, right.
Now, if you and it's really, it's one of those things that I can't get it right. But it's supposed to be, if you tap the reload button, it does a standard reload. You keep all the ammo. Right. Double tap reload, he'll drop that clip and get one. So it's a faster reload, but you lose bullets in the process.
Okay. Oh, really?
But I'm finding that I am hitting that button what feels like once, and it is still dropping the clip and doing the fast reload. So I wonder if they're going to patch something to make that a little more distinct. Because I feel like I need to just like go, eh, and barely tap reload to get the slow reload.
That'd be really interesting to see, actually, like the numbers, like a couple of months from now, of who actually does what.
Right.
Like, what's this, like, the strat on that one?
Yeah, but that's a cool idea. Like, the idea of, like, well, I need more bullets right now to handle this, and I'm willing to lose these to do it. Like, that's a strategically interesting change for them to make.
Tay, you've been playing this now. Well, you only started the campaign this morning.
Yep.
You went straight into multiplayer.
And this is probably, like, the most you'll play of the campaign, right? You're done.
Oh, yeah, I'm done.
Really?
Every time I've bought a COD, it's mainly to play multiplayer. Oh, that guy got messed up. It's mainly to play multiplayer because all my, like, I'm never super keen on playing Call of Duty. It's just one of those things that's like, oh, all my friends are going to play Call of Duty. Mm-hmm. We'll play like an hour or two a night and all right, cool. We're having fun, you know, like whatever.
And then wait for whatever's next and move on. Yeah, sure.
But yeah, no, this, like I said, everyone keeps asking me how I feel. I'm like, it's fun. I mean, like, it's Call of Duty with a twist. You know, it's like, they gave me a lime in my Coke, and they're like, yeah, it's great. It's
gave
nice
you a line of Coke?
A lime in my Coke.
Oh, sorry.
I guess a line of Coke would also do it, but...
Yeah, you didn't articulate
I wouldn't know that.
Go use a computer.
What you doing in Richmond at 3 in the morning is something to do with me.
Well, apparently you painted me as a guy that likes massages, and I get red-faced.
And
so
Coke.
Why not?
Coke.
Yeah. Great, sure.
You look wide awake out there in the Richmond.
Yeah, it's 3 a.m. I'm going to fall asleep during the massage, you know.
I come back and then I play Call of Duty.
You played like for 12 hours straight on day zero, I guess.
Yeah.
Is that going to become a thing? Is that going to be like the new thing? Halo going to have a day zero?
Like the end game for all this stuff is that as games get more and more digital, like, we're going to stop having release dates that, you know, there'll be a release date. Like, it'll definitely be available by this date. Mm. But at some point, someone's just going to go, like, look, the game's gold. Let's just start selling it.
But why not, like, if you pre-order it, then you get the digital release date?
Absolutely. But as retail kind of starts to sink further and further away, pre-order numbers are going to matter less and less.
Right.
That's the impression I get. So, like, you know, they only really care about pre-orders in terms of, like, they need to convince retailers to stock more copies of their game.
Right.
They need to have pre-order campaigns to get those numbers up so that GameStop buys more physical copies. As soon as we're all digital, like, they'll still do the pre-order stuff because they want to get your money as soon
and
as they
can. And headlines as well.
And lock it in and get their headlines. But, like, you know, the logistical reasons for it will eventually go away.
But will they start being like, hey, $10 extra, you get a whole 5 days in advance of everyone else. You come with the elite crew.
Well, I mean, that's
ahead of time.
Like the EA access thing is kind of that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you get the 7-day jump on everything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Then you still have to buy the game.
Yeah. That auto renewed for me yesterday. I was like, oh, yeah.
That's what you get.
I wanted to play that FIFA demo.
That's what you get for signing up to begin with.
Yeah.
You made your own bet on that.
I wanted to play FIFA.
And not setting a stern reminder to yourself.
Yeah, disconnect from it. Well, I guess I get to play Battlefield 3 whenever I want now, so that's great.
At least that one works.
My favorite thing that happened with EA purchases is once there was a bug on Origin where if you bought Mirror's Edge, one of the Battlefields, and I think it was Mercenaries 2, they wouldn't charge you for it.
Huh.
So everyone did it one day,
and
they've never taken them off anyone's account. Huh. So I still have...
You know, at some point, like, Origin was in that state of needing people to care about it no matter what.
Right.
And if they can give away three of their own games...
Yeah,
to get people to install Origin, it's probably worth it for them.
These guys are just running around in an open field aimlessly, and you're just zipping between them, blasting their faces.
I'm not really sure why I'm killing them all, but whatever. Kevin
this is one of those scenes where, like,
Kevin Spacey told me to kill.
You can really just run through, and they're all in disarray.
Oh, look at the evolution. Man. Quick.
How's that feel on your chest?
About the same.
Like a constant rumble.
The same. I think I would get more enjoyment just out of a rumble pack.
I don't think that's how that would fall down.
No?
No.
Well, let's go to Seattle and find out.
Go to Seattle. Let's mess up a nuclear plant cooling tower. Let's watch some videos from Fukushima.
I like the ones where they paint the faces on the falling towers. You ever see that one? And they're falling down the 2 hours.
Those GIFs.
Yeah. I prefer that. Is that a drone or is that just it's an actual helicopter?
Yeah,
it just looked like a drone.
Yeah. It's like
define drone, Danny. What does a drone mean to you?
I was about to say something which would definitely get me in a lot of trouble. about U.S. foreign policy, but sure. On that note, future warfare. That's one way to get rid of the problems in politics about warfare, is just set it in the future. Everyone hates PMCs, or do they?
We won't know until we get there.
Okay.
You know, when Google has their own military, then we can talk.
When?
When,
I mean.
Google they got driverless cars, like the next step. Is
what
just
do you
like,
think Uber
well, what
is?
If we put a gun on this car? I don't know. Just for kicks.
Just in case, hey. There's
someone wants to steal our driverless car. There's no one here to protect it, so we had to put a gun on it.
We need to have the villain on the inside just engineer a ring of carjackings in order to make that justifiable.
Yeah.
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 No, it's not going to happen.
Call of Duty Advanced Warfare 2. There's the plot for you. Right?
Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. You can win in one of those bad boys by going to tinyurl.com/...
Kadaw!
Win Kadaw!
Are you giving away the Windows version?
No, yes, the Windows version running on Xbox One. This is for North America only as well, I should remind all our European viewers.
Jeff, I think that would match your gold filigreed television really well.
Mm.
Yeah. Just go with the whole home decor you got going on.
You know, I'm good on consoles. I've managed to somehow get out of this whole, like, oh, the white Xbox One, oh, the white PS4. Like, I've managed to finally suppress that part of me to whatever extent necessary.
Congratulations.
And, yeah, you should trade in some of those old 360s and get those Xbox Ones with $100 off.
I have, like, all the models of 360. Really? Like, I bought the Xbox One-looking one. I have some of the other minis. And
do you have the top-loaded PS3 with the slidey thing?
No.
Ooh, the slidey
that's,
thing.
Yeah, that thing is just
a real piece of garbage.
Yeah, that thing's not great.
That thing's Janko.
Janko. That was single player. We'll single player edit away, just like when you play Call of Duty. Done. Forget about it forever. We're going to play some multiplayer pretty soon. But first of all, you guys have to leave the couch for a second because me and Jeff, we've got a special guest here today.
Mm-hmm.
Can we bring him on?
Bring him on. Yeah, we'll see you guys in a second.
We're going to bring on a WWE superstar.
What?
Just in a second.
Here?
Roman Reigns is here right now.
Right this second.
Before we blow your mind with that, we're going to check out that weird...
I think maybe we should look nice for him. We should probably, like, change or something.
You don't
something.
Like my dethrone?
I don't think this isn't...
You can't dethrone when you're here with Roman Reigns.
Should I? Would it be rude to change for him and then keep those clothes on when we come back with full multiplayer?
That would be incredibly disrespectful. I think we need to change our clothes and then change back into these clothes.
Yeah, we want you guys to be casual.
And you guys can come back then.
All right, cool.
Okay. Got it.
Fair enough.
GTA 5 single player first person shooter trailer coming up, and then we're back with Roman Reigns and me and Jeff looking super swank.
Here.
Hello, welcome back to the lobby. I'm very happy to be joined by WWE superstar and man that makes myself and Jeff look like tiny Lilliputian men. And also Call of Duty grenade spammer, Mr. Roman Reigns.
How you doing, sir? Thanks for having me.
Not at all. We were talking before we went live here about other video games, because of course Call of Duty's out today, officially.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I guess officially, like the pre-order thing was last night or whatever.
Day zero. Yeah. But you've got priors with Call of Duty. You've played it in the past.
When I had a little more time in my personal life, I played a little bit of Call of Duty. Big fan of the franchise, and kind of curious to where they're going with this. It seems like, you know, like we talked earlier, a kind of a Halo mix with the jumping and the spacesuits. So it'll be interesting.
Cool. You've obviously had a bit of downtime with your injury. You've played games in the past. Any games in the past couple of weeks that you've had to stay out of the gym a bit more?
Even on my off time, I don't even have that much time, because I take one hat off being a WWE superstar, and I put on another hat being a father. So going home, I got to play with, I have my little girl and my fiance. So it's been a good bit of family time, a little bit of vacationing. So a little more lounging than, I'm sure you both know, video games can be intense.
Yeah.
So you can have a little bit of stress going on in your life, even when you're having fun when you're on those things.
A little bit.
And then they also kind of,
just a little bit.
My hair's going gray here.
Mine went gray a long, long time ago.
Exactly.
And then, of course, they drag you out to San Francisco to talk to us about video games as well. It's all part of the business.
Well, they didn't drag me. They flew me, actually, first class pretty nicely. So it's not quite as bad as you think.
You're probably a lot more excited to come out here at the end of March, though, next year. Of course, the WrestleMania 31's on down in Santa Clara.
Yeah, where the Niners will be playing.
Go Niners. I'm a big Niner fan. I'm super proud of, having our little tiny event yet, right? The biggest entertainment event of all time here in San Francisco and Santa Clara at the new stadium. Hopefully, I'm going to put this out there. Hopefully I can meet the team, since we're going to be using their facility.
Sure.
Just throwing out a date there if you want to bite on that one.
I'm sure they'll all be the ones, hitting you guys up going, hey, can I get in?
I'm just going out on the limb. There's a few of the boys that I'm throwing the bait out now. 49ers, I'm hoping you bite. I want to see the facility, the new weight room. I imagine that it's just, I've heard it's like technology-wise, it's the sickest stadium of all time. So.
Now, you got priors in football as well. You used to play. You're Florida, though, right? So why the love for the Niners?
We
just got all love.
The majority of my family's from California.
Oh, cool.
When my dad was wrestling, going through the territories and things like that, it involved a lot of traveling, in a different way than we do it. A lot of times they would just kind of gypsy their way from town to town, territory to territory. Fortunately with us, we just fly in, fly out, back home at a central location. So once he started making his way to the East Coast, he saw Pensacola, Florida. It reminded him of the island.
Oh, really?
The beautiful white sand beaches, a real low key, not a big town at all. So it had that small hometown feel, but it just, the water and the sun reminded him, back of the South Pacific. So that's kind of how we migrated from the West Coast to the East Coast.
It's crazy because there seems to be a lot of wrestling pedigree down in Florida.
There's a tax break for independent contractors down
there. Oh, really?
Isn't there some other weird reason?
There's many benefits in Florida, is what I'd like to think. Yes, you save some money due to taxes, but like you said, there's a lot of rich tradition as far as wrestling down there. I mean, just the territory, you have the Grahams, Dusty Rhodes, even Hulkster, that was his, it's still his, hub, his home where he resides.
The Wyatts are down from down there as well, aren't they?
Well, the Wyatts as well, but there's just so many different, the Briscoes especially. That's a lot of, the newer generation may not know some of these names I'm talking about, but back in the day, the Briscoes were some of the biggest wrestling names of all time. So Florida, Texas, a lot of rich tradition in wrestling down in the South.
And you're involved down in Florida Championship Wrestling as well, is that correct?
Yeah, I was down there for a year and a half, 2 years, developmental system at the time. Now we're in Orlando, Florida, down at the Performance Center. So. Back in when I was there, I'm acting like a grandpa. Back in my day, this was like 3 years ago, so it wasn't that far ago. It was in a little warehouse. Now it's in like a Walmart facility.
Yeah.
It's huge. It's just second to none. It's on pretty much I think what Triple H, Stephanie McMahon, and Vince wanted to do is put it on that NFL level, and I think they exceeded that.
And a bunch of that stuff is in this year's game, actually. The Performance Center's in there. Of course, it's out. It was out last week on previous-gen consoles. It's out on current-gen consoles November 18th.
Yeah.
How much involvement do you, like, actually legitimately have on, like, that game? What do they need from you? Because we always hear about, like, mocap and voice and all that sort of stuff. Like, what did they just scan your face and then go, all right, go, you're done?
Well, I would say I have the most involvement ever. I mean, they needed me. They needed they needed this. They needed those other guys. They needed John Cena, Bray Wyatt, Cesaro. Mm. You know, without us, then there's no game. So I think I would. I'm a very critical point in this whole progression of video gaming at this point. Mm. But it was pretty neat because we did a lot of scanning, full body scanning, in and out of the gear, all different types of movements, flexing. Yeah, I mean, you can watch it right there. Just how fluid it is, the gameplay, the movement. They did a great job of studying, you know, the athletes that we are. You know, I move different than Randy Orton, and you can see that in the game. So I'm pretty impressed. It was a good bit of work as far as, you know, scanning and things like that. But, you know, if I'm not getting hit in the forehead or thrown on the ground, life's pretty easy.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if it needs to be realistic, then, I mean, obviously they got to mocap you just, you know, taking bumps, getting out there, doing stuff, right?
Well,
I mean,
if they want to get that far, then they need to get in the ring.
Right.
Throwing some trunks, get in the ring, and I'll show you what it feels like.
Yeah.
Yeah, getting injured and then having to dial into pay-per-views from the hospital.
Yeah,
all that,
like,
sort of stuff.
Did you do any mocap from a hospital bed? Like, we want realism here.
Well, they got realism there. I'm literally coming to, like, in and out of anesthesia, like, you know, just completely out of my mind. And, like, I'll see one doctor, I go out, come back, see two nurses, go out, come back, and I see half our office.
Oh, really?
Yeah, in the room, and I'm like, what? Yeah. Go out, next thing I know, hey, can you do an interview? I'm like,
oh, yeah. So that Night of Champions kind of cut that you did was your
oh, that
you
way,
remember,
I mean,
it?
In and out. I mean, it. Like, I have more vivid memories in my life, that's for sure. But that, I mean, it's 24/7. There's no days off in my job.
So what's that like then? Obviously, you've played games in the past. You were massive. You know, you've got that family, like, history with WWE as well. What's it actually like seeing yourself, like, in the game? It's a question we ask, like, every single person who's ever in a video game ever. But, like, considering you've actually played games in the past and you're a fan of them, like, is it kind of trippy seeing yourself in the game?
Yeah, I mean, and this is on a completely different level. You know, I was fortunate enough to play college ball, so I was in NCAA at the time. But it was funny at that point, like, to see the progression from my freshman year as I got better to being a senior.
Were your stats going up?
Yeah, my overall, and that was something, like, we always talked about, like, what was your overall?
Really?
What's your overall? Oh, that's some BS right there. I'm way better than this, but...
Would the players with the lower stats go, like, well, it doesn't use real names in there anyway, it's not really me.
Yeah,
they
yeah.
obviously didn't come look at me, because yeah. look.
That's not my complexion, I'm way tanner than that. But, like, just to see myself now and to be in this video game, to be a part of this, you know, and what I always describe the difference between football and wrestling is I'm not wearing a helmet.
Yeah.
So it's really neat to see all the details, you know, just how the graphics, the realism, yeah, and like we talked about earlier, the movement, the gameplay, everything's so smooth. It just seems so real. It's incredible.
It's getting to that point now. It's something that, you know, like 2K's basketball game, I think, has been like this for a while now. And now, like, seeing that stuff applied to wrestling, it's that moment where, like, if you're kind of looking out of the corner of your eye, or kind of not, you're like, oh, someone just watching TV over there? Someone just, oh, is Raw on? What are we doing over there? It's like, oh, hang on, okay, all right. No, wait, okay, that's a video game. And that's just been super fun. I mean, I think back to, you know, just like all the older wrestling games, and just like some of them were pretty busted over the years.
Yeah.
It's like everyone's got the exact same moveset, you know, it's like no flair, no realism compared to like the real movesets and stuff, just being able to see, like, you move like you.
Well, I just saw me jumping off the second row for like a splash. That, let's not get crazy, people. I'm not ever doing that, okay? I like to keep my feet on the ground, but like
there
just
you go.
That.
Yeah.
I mean, and like you were saying, I'm over here looking at you, but then in my peripheral, it feels like they're just showing highlights from Raw.
Mm-hmm. Do you ever look at, I mean, maybe you can speak for just some of the other guys on the roster, you know, do you ever kind of look at the games and, you know, it's like people can create their own finishers and do all this different stuff. You ever look at it and maybe get inspired, like, oh, maybe that's something I could try, like maybe I could pull this off? Or is it kind of, you know, you're you know what you want to do in the ring and just do it?
I mean, I'm always willing to try new stuff. You know, I have my nucleus of things I like to do, my style. But like literally, I just saw, I think, you know, in the video game, I just scooped up Randy and I, you know, did like a backbreaker, a side breaker or whatever. And that's something like even that looked good and it looked like me doing it. You know what I mean? So that's something when anytime you see, you know, anybody that looks like you or moves like you, that's something that's always helped me is I come from a wrestling family.
Yeah.
You know, when I watch, you know, my family members before me or even now, I can really touch base with their movements, their athleticism. So when I watch, you know, any of my former, you know, family members with the WWE, when I watch their matches, I can visualize myself doing it because we have a similar skill set.
You never thought about just like editing your character and like sticking a 619 in there or 5-star frog splash?
I mean, you're picking out easy moves, man. But everybody can just run through the ropes. You know what I mean?
Not me.
I'm pretty nifty in the ring, but I could never imagine, you know, going through the ropes. Mm. And I always think about that, like when I would watch Seth and Dean dive or, you know, guys do the dives. How much skill is involved with not getting tangled up in the ropes?
Yeah.
But to be like Rey Mysterio and bounce off the second rope and then to be able to do a full, that's like a gymnastic movement. Mm. I mean, but that's 20, almost 30 years of experience. So. Yeah. And a Hall of Famer at that. So I'm not going to, I'll probably go maybe with the axe handle. You know, I'm not going to go straight to a 619 or a frog splash. You got to.
Baby steps.
You got to crawl before you walk and walk before you run. So maybe we'll go to that second rope splash before we do a full out 5-star frog splash. Getting so crazy today.
It's been a lot of fun to watch you run with the Shield and then, you know, since the breakup of the Shield, like it seems like all three of you have just been like rocketing up the card. And really just getting up there into the, you know, these closer and closer to these main event spots and stuff. How hard is it being out right now and watching like Seth and Dean just going like, man, I could be in there. Just like I could be in the mix with this right now.
Yeah, I mean, it's always, you know, it's tough when you have a situation like this. Being on the sideline, the way I look at it, I'm a starter. You know what I mean? I'm a first string guy. I belong in the game. I don't come out of the game. That's how I've always looked at it. I've had this hernia for a long time. And even in football, I just learned how to play with it because when you have injuries, that means you're missing games, you're missing time, missing stats, missing money. There's a lot of things on the line here. You know, positioning, number one contendership. There's so many different things that I'm missing out on. But at the same time, being a positive person, I got to think that everything happens for a reason. These guys, you know, they're doing their thing for a reason. This is happening to me for a reason. But when I get back, I mean, it's balls to the walls. I'm unleashing hell on everybody.
Great.
I don't care if we are brothers, sisters, whatever. You know, a father, son, I'm taking everybody and anybody out I can. And that's just, it's a take no prisoner mentality is the way I'm looking at it.
You're involved, obviously, with WrestleMania 30 with The Shield. You kind of want to get your name, just Roman Reigns, on the sheet for 31? Like, is that kind of your goal now? Because it's like TikTok at this stage. You got like 4 months.
Well, like you said, we got 4 months. I don't see a Shield reuniting in four months. You know, God, I hope not. there's so much more to it than that, I would think. Yeah, I mean, I think anybody wants to get their name on that card. For so many different reasons, you know, to lock your place into history, you know, to compete for, you know, on the grandest stage of them all, to have the whole world see you, you know what I mean? Yeah. There's so much pride, so much respect that goes into this, you know, and it's a tradition that we're carrying on. So, you know, getting on that card as a singles competitor, that'll be a whole new level for me.
Well, if we look at kind of the timetable of where we're at right now, I mean, you know, here we are, early November. I feel like this is right around the time of year that people start to sit back and wonder, like, okay, Rumble's coming up.
Yeah.
Who's injured? Like, who can make their mark returning at the Rumble, winning the Rumble, going on to main event WrestleMania, like all that sort of stuff. Does that timetable make sense for where your injury's at right now?
Yeah, I mean, I think it does. You know, I don't...
I mean, obviously, like, yeah, I mean, who
I'm know. Not writing the history
exactly.
books,
yeah.
but, you know, I think so, and I think I'm that type of player, you know, I'm the type of guy that can be put in that position, you know, not everybody can, pretty, so you, I'm, And it may be fitting because we're in San Francisco and the World Series is going on, but sometimes
the World Series is over, actually. And wasn't that a fantastic Game 7?
And that's what happens when you fly and you travel is you lose track of time.
Exactly.
It's a crazy time zone situation down here, like wormholes and things like that. It's like the Matrix out here. It's crazy.
Yeah.
We're in video game world. This ain't even real. But, you know, with that analogy is you have a leadoff hitter. You know, you have your guy, you know, you have your like a get on base guy, a sacrifice fly guy, a guy who bunts. Mm. I'm a grand slam hitter. I'm a home run guy. I'm a cleanup guy. So, you know, I think that fits for a guy coming back in the Royal Rumble, you know, out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Unfortunately for me, which I think is pretty cool, is we've had some updates. You know, the people have seen me, which you don't usually, that's not
right.
something that happens
you've
often.
You've been on TV, fresh in people's minds. Yeah.
Yeah, it feels almost like a NFL or a, you know, NBA type feel, you know, being on SportsCenter, just kind of, hey, here I am, doing better now. But I think there's some requirements. You got to have some things in order to just be back in the Rumble and make something happen, you know, and which I think I've shown that I can do.
Yeah,
that.
I mean, last year, I mean, you ran that thing.
Ring.
Yeah, it was almost.
It was almost my ring.
Before we let you go, obviously, it's interesting to hear you talk about wish fulfillment and the sort of, you know, prophesizing about what you would like to do. For people who are playing these games, it's often about, like, putting yourself in scenarios and situations that you want to see, like the matchups you want to have with your creator wrestler. Or what I used to do a lot with the old games was like match up people who were my two favorite wrestlers on my face and my heel and then see them fight. When you play this game, like what's like the ultimate like matchup that you'd like to do with like somebody past, present, somebody in your family or like a favorite you had growing up? Like who would you like to fight against?
There'd be so many, and that's the beauty of this game is you can just continue to create these matchups. You know, you can be up till 5 a.m. doing this, and I know people will be. I may be one of them. But I would think, from my family, I'd probably say Yokozuna or Umaga, maybe. Just I think they would be great matchups, you know, using their size and their explosiveness, their athleticism compared to mine, you know, with a little bit different, well, a good bit difference in our build. But I think the explosion and the strength is all very similar. I wouldn't mind a triple threat match, or, you know, a former Shield member triple threat match for, you know, the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, of course. I think... that would be very fitting, you know, to have that type of match with, you know, that much emotion on the line, but also have the hardware hanging in front of us. So I think that would be pretty neat. You know, easy, you know, a kind of a cheap answer would be Undertaker or Sting, you know, even Ric Flair for that matter. I've had a couple matches where he's been our special guest referee.
Mm. Just want to hit him.
Not necessarily. I just want to be out there with him one-on-one and just create that energy. He's such an energetic guy, and he just gets this reaction. And it's amazing being out there and just seeing him and seeing how he works in front of people and his, you know, just his emotion and that energy and that enthusiasm that he brings. It's electric, and I wouldn't mind being a part of that.
Cool. Well, Roman, thank you so much for coming on. We look forward to seeing many matchups with you in the future. And, best of luck with the recovery. And hopefully we'll see you at Rumble and WrestleMania as well.
Cool. Thanks for having me, guys.
That's WWE 2K15. It's out currently on previous-gen consoles. It's out on November 18th on your Xbox One and your PlayStation 4. Stay tuned to the lobby. We'll be back in a second.
That one with the Why do you hate skeleton hands so holding the heart? Yeah.
Wow.
That's weird.
This new teleporter chance technology is pretty great. Roman Reigns, everyone. Did we talk about video games for like about 2 minutes of that, I feel?
I mean, we just did it, but I can't remember anything about it.
Yeah.
There's some COD talk, right?
That guy's limber. He got off really quick. Yeah. Kay and I just hopped back in. We were behind the couch the whole time.
Yeah.
Roman Reigns, Call of Duty player.
Yeah.
Maybe not so much these days. He's on the road 300 days a year or whatever it is, but, you know.
He's got his family.
Yeah.
Didn't play many video games when he was off injured. As you know, because he was just here
He was just here speaking about it.
On the lobby. GameSpot. Video games and wrestling. Actually, speaking of video games and wrestling,
hello.
In a few minutes, you guys are going to go upstairs and record a Power Bombcast with Roman Reigns.
Right, yes. And then we'll record that, and it will be up, hopefully, over on Giant Bomb sometime this week. I need to watch some wrestling.
Right.
The last month has been not so good.
Hell in the Cell.
Yeah. You got a bone up on it?
Yeah.
Get your
bone on.
Get your bone.
Eric, you've still survived. The C4 vest is still here, and I believe we're going to play some multiplayer, and it's time for Dress Up.
You want to play Dress Up?
You want to play Dress Up? Show me some of your stuff. Look at this.
Nice hat.
I wish.
Wear sunglasses behind your thing. Atlas Vigilante sunglasses.
Nice.
They
look good.
Let me see. Oh, why doesn't it show there?
Because it's a video game. They never do it right.
There you go.
Look at that.
Or do you want a helmet?
Oh, that's pretty good.
What do you want, the beanie?
What about the assassin mask?
I don't think it's going to show up.
No. Is that mask something you just unlock at a certain level, or is that a drop?
It's the Kevin Van Or... Oh, no, okay.
That one might
have just been... It's like that Crisis suit.
I feel like I see a lot of people wearing it, so I assume it's like at some point in your 30s, near level 30 or something.
It's like that thing. It's like, oh, see, check me out, I'm level 30. Yeah. Do you lose all your stuff when you prestige?
You get to keep one thing.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Or anything, anything. So like hard lines, like at 47. So maybe that's a thing you consider.
What did
I don't
you
know.
Choose?
I think scavenger, because I got really sick of the reloading thing. Yeah. No problem. So now that I can't run out of bullets, it's like.
Oh, the double tap reload stuff.
Double tap square. I just press square now. Like whatever, it doesn't matter.
I got time for no double taps.
Thanks to everyone, by the way, who entered our competition for the Xbox One and Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. We have a winner. Gonna announce it at the end of the show, because I'm a jerk. All right, let's play some video game. Let's get in there.
Hold on.
Too much dress up happening here.
Why?
There's Why? Just
half the battle.
Looks
Look
really
at that.
Cool.
Looks so bad, eh?
Can you play as Kevin Spacey in multiplayer?
No.
Fuck this.
Not game. Yet.
Not yet.
DLC?
Yeah. You think? I mean, they sold, like, for Ghosts. They rolled out, like, well, let's just sell whatever we can. Oh, God, we got to maximize money on this thing. Snoop Dogg announcer.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah. So. Yeah. That's Spacey. Pretty great. No, there's no Kevin Spacey announcer for, but you know, but yeah, I mean, they sold astronauts and all kinds of weird stuff.
Yeah.
So who knows?
Maybe when House of Cards comes back around, they'll do like a
Frank something.
Underwood version of him as well.
Mm. I want them to put it in, and then it turns out in his contract he thought that he wasn't actually authorizing that, and then he sues them, like No Doubt style.
No Doubt
was no, no doubt what, was the oh, band yeah. that sued them yeah, for yeah, Band Hero. Yeah.
I want to say Courtney Love got in on that for a little bit, too.
Yeah. Okay. Well, as she would want to do.
If there was a lawsuit involving music, you can guarantee Courtney Love will be around.
All right, Tay. C4 is going to go bang, bang, unless you start murdering fools.
See how he just outplayed me by doing the jump stuff that I'm
no,
not used
to? No, let's
doing
watch the kill
duty.
Cam of you getting outplayed
no,
every
this brings
time.
That never happened.
To like a whole new level. You just descend your gamer balls on someone from 15 feet. God, you can really jump around. I don't think I appreciated that in the single player.
Oh, yeah.
This guy's whipping me.
I like it just running along, double jumping, and then side boosting to land on something, and then just continuing to move.
Yep.
Like, there's just a lot of real seamless motions you can do. Jump past, boost past someone, turn in the air, and land looking at them.
Yeah.
Gun down right there. That's always fun. Or knife them, you know, that's fun.
I just like running around, side boosting and stuff, just to be weird and be unpredictable.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't work all the time. I'm not very good at Call of Duty, and I usually get killed, but like...
Well, I love the people that seem to be using him, because they had all this shit in Unreal Tournament for years, and nobody ever used any of it. Like the double tap sideways,
I feel like a lot of the double tap on keyboard stuff was, like, too much for a lot of people.
Yeah,
like, I got into that stuff. All that movement stuff was great, but, yeah, it was hard to find great places to use it.
Yeah. That was pretty fast, and it didn't go very far either.
It didn't go very far, yeah. Nice. And you're also... You're competing against players that are using a mouse, and like the amount of mouse movement required to just keep your aim on, not that much.
What is with these iron sights you're rocking here today?
What about them? Got a problem?
Yeah. What is why?
Actually, I'm gonna try to punch him and probably whiff.
And totally whiff.
Oh, he's got an insanity. No. Give me that.
Oh, this is the pick up someone's gun that's way better, and then you feel terrible when you die again.
One more coming.
What makes this gun
around
insane?
To the left. He went around to the
no,
left.
No, it's one of the elite ones.
Mm. How do you know?
Oh,
gold?
Behind you. Oh.
Good call, though.
Yeah, he did. He had that one.
Insane is like a tier of, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, no,
or
I think
no,
that's just
like
a naming
enlisted,
convention
elite,
for
it.
Yeah,
like,
these random weapon variants will drop.
From a supply crate.
Yeah.
That seems random, and there's only been one time where I actually killed someone and got a supply crate. It seems like every time you die, you get a supply crate.
It's like first death of the day or something.
Does that still happen? That was happening during the review event that I went to play a bunch of multiplayer, and it was like the first death of every match
while. It still happens.
It wasn't the first death of every match for me with the real thing, but It's definitely been.
Does that just mean every reviewer was going out running into a fucking go, do it, do it,
give me that crate,
smoke me.
I wouldn't be surprised if like they just to show off how that system worked, they were making it drop more frequently, so right. people
That's
could get a look
thinking.
At the custom
stuff. It
would
not be the case once.
But
once
it's not quite the case okay. with the final game.
I think for me, it's been like if I did good like the last round, like the moment I die, the next round, I pretty much get a supply crate, but I can't.
And you get, and so it'll like pop up. It'll say supply crate earned, but you don't get to pop this thing open until the end
of
the match
yeah.
right? And okay. see what you got, which could be like guns or clothing or
like double XP.
Yeah, like
or the drops.
Yeah, or yeah, rapid supply.
Do you still have supply drops mid game?
Yes,
airdrops,
crates, and
yeah, crates, yeah. And stuff.
Orbital.
Yeah. The ones you get seem to be on a timer paced, where like you'll get it like in 2 minutes or 4 minutes. It's kind of almost like the Titanfall, like the wild cards,
right,
you know,
yeah,
like you
yeah.
just get it, it's just like something you get, and sometimes it's like, there's like map-specific score streaks now too, which is kind of interesting, like there's like a tram that has like machine guns, there's one with like war tanks and you shoot rockets, so, yes.
How's all the grenade stuff in this? I mean, they had that decoy grenade thing I remember seeing, did you ever use that?
I don't use any of the grenades, you're a grenade guy, right?
You know, here and there, like the default grenade in multiplayer is it's a wrist mount thing like Black Ops.
Shoot it
so
off.
You kind of shoot it off and it fires off at a much lower arc. So that Red Baron cap that you just got is time limited.
What?
It's
how can you
when
tell?
When you get it, it'll last for 30 minutes of game time and then expire.
Use it.
It's weird.
Does it give you any perk, or
no,
does it just look sick?
It just looks. It's like it lets people know, like, hey, you killed someone in the air while you were in the air at some point in the last 30 minutes.
Right. Because everyone's supposed to know that.
You can also get some like item that extends the longevity.
Oh, really? Okay.
But it's like, whatever.
Whatever.
Yeah, look, I'm a pilot guy.
Like, the expiring cosmetic items is like the dumbest, most pokey-ass free-to-play business. Like, it's real scary. You look at it and go like, what are they doing? Like, all this weird cosmetic shit that drops and all this, like, at some point, are they just going to go like, hey, you want to buy some helmets?
You want the Red Baron hat you can have forever?
You want to buy a hat pack?
Oh, we got...
It's precedented.
Yeah, it's I don't know.
It's a pretty nice hat.
The Blood Hunter.
Nice work, Tay. You look like an even bigger douchebag now.
Good. Oh, yesterday I had a pink unicorn emblem, but I don't have that.
You need like a cigarette in a cigarette holder. I feel like you're like you could be Hunter S. Thompson on like some kind of weird military embed assignment here.
Sure.
Just get Gonzo with it.
Is Juice and Gin your game?
It's pronounced Juice Engine.
Juice
no, that's how Sean says it, and that's not how you say it. And the only reason why, as lame of a name as it is because I played BlazBlue.
Okay, BlazBlue, yeah.
All good things start from, well, I used to play BlazBlue.
And it was an anime fighter, and the guy I played was Jin. So, you know,
all right.
Somebody had juice, Jin and Juice, so I had to do it the opposite.
But nice
the
work. Jin it's is funny, with a J. I get it. It's funny.
Thought it was because you love consuming juice and refer to yourself as a juice engine because you only thrive during the day when you're all
juiced up.
Got to fuel up the juice
steroids.
Engine.
Steroids.
Sure. Yeah.
Ride the juice dragon.
That's what he tells all those masseuses. Ride the juice engine. What's happening here? What map is this? Are the maps good in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare?
I like the maps.
The maps are good.
Okay.
There's only one I don't like.
Which one is it?
I can't remember the name. It's the one with the koi fish. It actually looks really cool. But I
is that the one that has the big area in the middle where you just fall over and over again?
Yes.
I, like but the, I actually like that
you
one.
You can make it across. You
yeah.
just need to, like,
oh,
jump,
yeah,
dash,
that elevated
dash.
One.
Is it Morpheus?
Yes.
From Unreal Tournament? Okay.
No.
I'm back in.
Matrix?
No, from Unreal Tournament.
I want to say that's called Green Band. I can't remember. That might be a different map. I don't know. Who remembers the names of maps anymore?
Yeah, I don't.
Anyway.
Any new modes you're playing on?
Team.
Team.
First death.
They've got Momentum, which is War from Call of Duty, World at War.
It's I can't
like
remember
a,
that one.
It's a like a symmetric, it's a linear progression point capture map. So you'll have five flags across a map.
Right.
The middle one will be activated. When you capture that, you push further into their territory, further into their territory. Whoever gets all the flags, their color wins.
Cool.
It's like Team Fortress 2.
Yeah, TF2 has that.
Yeah.
And then there's Uplink, which is their like basketball soccery weird mode.
Oh, great!
It's like there's a Halo mode that's a lot like that.
I know I've literally talked about Unreal Tournament five times too much on this already. Bombing run.
Yeah. So basically, we'll get into it, I guess. But a satellite that happens to be shaped like a ball drops at a set point in the map. There are two goals floating at either end of the map, basically.
You can't shoot when you're holding the thing?
Yeah, but you can melee and kill people with it, and that's fun. There's one of the medals in the game is for passing an enemy the ball and then killing them and getting the ball back, which is fun.
That's a really fun move.
Why would you do that?
Come on.
It's 2014.
Don't embarrass yourself.
That's like old man tactics now.
That was how I, like, one of the things about Ghosts that really rubbed me the wrong way is that they codified and rewarded teabagging.
Really?
It was one of the field orders was humiliate the next enemy you kill. And it never told you what that meant.
Yeah.
But sure enough. Dicks.
Hey, it's not cool anymore.
It never was cool. It was always a dick.
It's not a 10 kill.
Now it's just a real tired
freaking
dick.
Clown guy. Who would ever use that emblem?
That guy. So
he just wants to piss you off.
Yeah.
It's working.
Yeah, it is.
He's in your head. Whoa. You're like, is that
clown cool
guy?
So, although what you did afterwards, you kind of step one was real good.
Yeah. That was just bad aim. I had
sound
bad
fundamentals
aim.
And then bad fundamentals.
Or follow through.
This map is where all the killing happens.
Just run into it and then people.
Yeah, just run into it over and over again and die.
Jump on top of the spaceship in the middle of the room.
And then four people in four different spots all start shooting you.
Is there much variety in the maps? Like. Size-wise, like this and the previous one look like they're about the same kind of, you know, because they can't be that small.
Not
that
much
jumping around. They're all kind of a basic size. This game does have Ground War in it, which will have an 18-player cap instead of the default 12, which is fun if you want to fill those maps up and, you know, just kill a bunch or die a bunch. But I feel like generally the map size is roughly the same. They don't have like a shipment equivalent, you know, like you know, they always used to have like here's one map that's super tight because you want to set up a weird custom game where you're just killing people over and over again on this map forever and filling it full of kill
Farm
streaks
XP.
And basically like you want prestige tomorrow, get on this map.
Has everyone prestige already?
Probably.
From day zero?
He did.
I know you did, but like, do you see other people that have?
There's people, there's plenty of people. I've also seen the, you know, those people that bought black market copies. They're like two prestiges.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This got leaked a good, decent, like five, six days early, right?
Yeah, I mean, we got copies in last week, and there were already people on the servers, so it was definitely like...
Were they blocking accounts?
No.
Right.
No, at some point, that's actually really useful as a reviewer when copies get out early. It used to be one of those like dirty, like unspoken things about the Xbox 360 is like once piracy had become a problem on the Xbox, that was the one you wanted as a reviewer because there would always be pirates playing the game early, and so you could test out the multiplayer ahead of time
against
PS3. Yeah. Up until the PS3 became weird in its own way, you would get and the servers would be empty because.
Be like,
those copies wouldn't leak.
Hey guys, do you want to maybe get together and like play a little bit?
Yeah, but
I know this one other guy. We can get two versus two. We can at least see what the maps are like.
Yeah, we can look at the maps.
We can like shoot some guns a little bit.
But yeah, the 360 was the if you wanted to play multiplayer early,
that's
you would play against filthy pirates on the 360.
Oh, that'll do it.
How do you like the ragdolling post death?
Yeah,
it's pretty good in this one.
It's different to the same five death animations over and over again.
Yeah,
that's how you know it's next gen, man.
There are a few that are just
you can feel it.
Some are so silly and just really give you like a nice little comedic relief. Like, are you kidding me? I just did like a flat spin. That was fantastic.
And this red Baron hat comes off. Is that the Verizon logo? What is that? Close.
Visio drone.
That's what Verizon's going to rename itself to in about 2046.
Once it starts getting into like oil capping.
They got a hold of leaked documents.
Nice.
You keep saying nice before you actually kill somebody.
Rewind, no, we watch this again. This is great. guys are right about those melees.
Yeah, melee.
You're going to see a lot of punch dancing where, you know, you're just like, hey,
what's up?
What's up?
Come on.
They should put a Scout's Knives equivalent in this thing.
It's like an SNL sketch of like the two guys with the shortest arms ever trying to punch each other.
That's like I'm going to say that's like an 80s era SNL. Charles Rocket doing the news. The dark times is when they wrote that bit.
Yep. It's not a compliment.
Any of you guys play the PC version?
Yeah.
Any?
It's fine.
Anything to?
Yeah.
60 frames a second.
Yeah, you know, runs well. You can run at a higher resolution. There are a lot of options in there. You can like preload pre-cache shaders and do all this other. You know, there's a bunch of more options than I feel Call of Duty has had in the past on the PC.
Right.
You know, there's an FOV slider right there. You know, different stuff like that. But
you play some uplink.
Oh, I thought it was going to be worse than that. I was feeding like crazy.
I love how you needed to make sure you had the vest on before
chest,
you.
Chest vest situation up.
You got to make sure your FX are in your core.
Yeah. Well, it's not really though, because it's like right to the chest. I feel like my core is like down here.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't know. It's not gonna do.
Can
anything
you just put
right
on
now.
Like Just Dance and it'll just keep going all the time?
Yes. Oh, okay. So like when it was
open
on
the crate.
So it because it runs on. All right, crate.
Production.
Oh, no! The crate. I felt it.
Oh yes. A Val 27, I'll take that.
You can only use it for 14 minutes.
No, you can use that the whole
you can use
time.
That one
I'm
for
sorry
three
you didn't
minutes
get to feel it in your chest when you got the.
Did you open
27.
Up the crate and you felt it in your chest? That's a new game
experience
right
there.
Because
it runs off of all audio. Right?
You'll never be able to go back to opening chests without having that.
No, it's just going to feel empty.
Look at that guy.
Oh, actually, we instead of playing dress up, we can just like.
You
watch,
can leave. You want to play uplink, right?
Yeah, yeah. You need to leave.
I would like to leave the lobby.
I will say though that so that, hey. That blue version of the gun has a scope. So
I'm
you
done
don't
here.
Have to add the scope
right.
Yourself,
yeah.
So
you
that's
can kind of
have
a scope for a free
yeah,
point
a free
as long as you
scope.
Like that scope. Yeah.
You guys like this rail gun?
Use the my elite one.
I like the rail gun.
That's pretty good.
Use my elite one.
Use your elite what?
I have an elite rail gun.
I know you have an elite rail gun. The class that I made
code?
For uplink has
code?
No elite rail gun.
I don't want to hear about it.
It just has a knife and a real speedy SMG. And I'm going to run around like a maniac trying to dunk uplink balls into people's faces.
I can't wait to see this. Uplink.
This mode always seems like the mode that the people who made this game probably really like playing.
Right.
And that most of the people who bought it want nothing to do with it.
Will this be the mode that you'll play when you're bored of everything else?
I do like it a lot, because I'm not that good at normal Call of Duty.
I loved Bombing Run loads, but no one was ever playing it.
Yeah.
You needed like 12 people, at least, to play that game.
Well, I mean,
it was just
like,
you and one other dude, and if you went down the left lane of the map, he'd never see you. So you'd spend like 2 minutes running down this Unreal Tournament map, and then dunking it.
Let's see these different outfits. What do we got?
It was pretty evident, too, on like day zero. I was going to say day one, but I guess day zero, that like... There were three big modes that everyone was playing. It was TDM or Team Deathmatch.
Mm.
I think Domination and Kill Confirm. And
like those
every
are the big
other
three,
game,
though,
yeah, every other game, I tried to find an uplink game just to, you know, because some people wanted to see it. I was like, all right, let's try. Four people in there, like the same four people trying to wait and hope that four more people join.
That guy looks cool. Look at that guy.
Steve Jesus.
He looks super shady.
He is hard living.
I've
that
got
guy.
A knife. He says,
yeah.
Languish? Lagush?
Lagos?
Lagos.
Lagos. Oh, we're in Nigeria. Sorry. No, I feel like
I got some Nigerian police pants yesterday.
Oh, did you?
Very exciting.
Nice.
That sounds like prison lingo.
Not yet. Not yet. Oh, I got the helmet. I got the pants, but... Oh, holding out hope. Get the boots and the chest and the gloves. And
got some of that Nigerian police pants.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I hooked up a
real
bag
push.
Of that Nigerian police pants.
I like this map. This map's good.
Yeah.
This map's fun.
This looks like a Call of Duty map that's in every Call of Duty map. This looks like real.
Son of a bitch.
Oh, yeah, you're not in
Lagos. Why would there be a banner for Lagos in Lagos? That seems like. Come to Lagos! Oh, you're here already. Sorry. Unless this isn't in Lagos. Is this in Abuja, the former capital city of Nigeria?
Woohoo!
Yeah, dropping Nigeria bombs.
What?
Yeah, sorry.
I'm confused.
This is GameSpot's
geography
stream, right? Is that the ball?
Yeah, he's got the ball right now.
Sweet!
It's a satellite or whatever, right?
You get a. Both activated at once. That's crazy.
There's a guy to your left.
You threw it. You wanted to slam dunk.
I want to slam dunk all the time.
Throwing it is one point. Running it through yourself is two.
Yeah, but sometimes...
Is it hard to throw it?
You sense the heat in it. You just got to dump it. It's like...
It's really easy to throw.
It's like the opposite of basketball.
It's like soccer, but good.
Hey.
What?
I won't be having that.
I'm sorry. It's like football, but good.
All right, that's slightly better.
Okay.
I like football, though, but it's okay. I'm okay with it.
Oh, what the fuck is that? Was that what
they
happens
score,
in the score?
Yeah.
Wow. What's the... is there any story reason for
it's
why
a
this
satellite.
Is happening?
You've got to hack the... you got to uplink the satellite.
Well, it's a field lattice generator. Is that what you're telling me?
Yes, exactly.
Right. Fuck. Ooh, that guy's pretty good.
Skeet shooter. Skeet.
The one thing that still pees me though about Call of Duty is Advanced Warfare, it's like every other Call of Duty in that like you're fighting someone, you think you killed them, and then you watch the kill cam and you're like, oh, latency.
Yeah, the kill cams are never good. And they never have been. At some point you would have thought they would have taken them out.
Yeah.
Just because it's very easy to watch it and go, what the hell just happened?
Exactly. I have too many of those. No way. And
all right.
Oh, shit.
That was a bad throw.
That was a
you
real.
Almost did they know where you are right now?
Just run it in there.
Slam dunk.
I told you I shouldn't be throwing nothing.
This is way more frantic than I was expecting. This map is pretty small.
Well, it's one of those things. You know, the movement speed in this game makes all the maps a little smaller.
Right. Yeah.
You know, and that's pretty fun.
Now go in the window.
I mean, after playing Destiny multiplayer, coming to this, it was like a whole different world. Just because the speed is insane.
Yeah, it's crazy. This game is like good and fun, and Destiny multiplayer is sluggish. Like, why would anyone ever play it?
Whoa.
All right, Sophie's choice.
We've got
to
get crucible marks.
What? You need crucible marks to get your gear.
I got enough, and I never have to play it again.
Yeah, well,
it's pretty.
You and Brad seem to have this golden luck, golden ticket of just getting gear the first couple times.
Tay, pick one.
Pick one for what?
Pick one. Sophie's choice. You're going to play one of these games for next
no,
month.
The right way.
The next month? I'm playing this until Destiny DLC comes out. This is my filler. I'm still doing my Destiny raids, but I mean, that's just once a week.
Something like, randomly dropped?
Once a week, you meet up with your friends, you do the raid, and then you play something else.
Yeah, all right.
You know, at him. Yeah! Make the plays, Chris! He doesn't know what to do!
I mean, at some point, I may go get 500 machine gun kills to get whatever the exotic machine gun bounty I've got.
Okay. Maybe it's a Nigerian police shock machine gun.
But that's the kind of stuff you can do in this mode that's kind of fun. That I saw Chris do, which is like you say, you throw the ball to the guy, he's like, oh, I can't shoot anymore.
Right, yeah,
and
yeah.
He doesn't know to throw it back, and it's like, okay, you get generally it's an easy kill. But.
Hassan in chat says Eric Tay has a problem. I tend to agree.
I don't have any. Maybe, yeah. That's when you know you have a problem. Right? Yeah. I don't have a problem.
Denial's the first sign.
Oh, totally.
Like that kind of death where you just like go into the slow spin in the air.
There was that one clip of someone dying and like their feet were out like this and they just fell down like that.
Weird.
Like they sat. It was like they died and they just sat up.
Dark.
Sat up right. Yeah, J-Lo 84.
You just say this is Madden 15.
This is better than
GTA
Madden 15.
Yeah.
Great.
It's
guy.
A really
I'm
great.
Feeling
you know,
that guy right in my chest.
It's that time of the year, you know, when we get to play Call of Duty and get to play a fresh Call of Duty and remind ourselves, like, boy, the last thing I want to do is talk to anyone that plays Call of Duty.
Are you surprised at all that they kept the kind of like 1 second after you kill them thing in the game?
Oh, like that you can hear them.
The whole like, no way.
That is my favorite use of voice chat in just about any game. Is that. Like to be able to kill someone and hear them go like, "Fuck!" You know, like.
Nope, no mantling there. Not gonna run there. This guy doesn't see me. He doesn't know how to play this mode.
I got a question. I gotta find out who
asked
this question.
Oh
yeah. Somebody in the chat. I'm sorry, I didn't see the name. Ask Chris. Are you doing a gun show episode on this?
I would like to, but
if we
that's
have time.
Gonna be time depending because like. There's reviews and other stuff, and oh god, so much. But all right, yeah, I'd like to do one on like exo abilities. Like with Call of Duty, it's always tough to do a gun show because
because they're all such known quantities or something.
Yeah, or also because there's so friggin' many.
Right.
Wow.
So that was because I exoed the stim and the.
You can get away with this shit on day one.
Yeah, right. But I had my two exos, the fast one and the fast healing.
Yeah, a lot of people don't understand like that. Like a short jump into like the boost is going to get you there further than like running.
Yep.
You
know?
It's like the little thing like that.
Yeah,
like,
I'm good. I'm solid at Call of Duty on day one. But my game does not hold up over time.
I remember going back to Gears of War 3. About 3 months after it came out, and like just impenetrable. People got so good at that.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Oh,
you know,
that stuff.
You're either going to be the sort of player that likes to play multiple games, or you're going to devote yourself to something for the long haul. And that's the thing that, you know, I think for people that do like to play different games from time to time, it ruins multiplayer in a lot of games. You know, you get to a point where you kind of can't come back to it anymore.
Did you feel like you're like part of? I feel like more and more the majority of people are sticking to one and two games a year, and not like
playing dozens.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, for multiplayer stuff, certainly.
But even a kid's like, or like, or like, or like Dota or Minecraft,
well,
or like Skyrim, you know.
Minecraft will be the game that puts us all out of work because people are just going to play that forever and never buy another game again.
It's like slowly will absorb all gaming activities as we know it. So one thing that you're totally not seeing that like you can do in this mode if you ever get any type of team together is...
pass it?
Yes. You can pass the ball to your teammates.
Is it difficult? Do you have to really nail it to them? Because
no, like, anytime there's a teammate in your field of view, left trigger is to automatically throw it
great
to them.
Great, okay. That was not the case in Bombing Run?
Yeah, it's a smart... That is a smart thing for them to do.
Any kind of jump just looks the silliest.
Holding that invisible ball. Oh. Look!
Outplayed.
What? That was so many hit markers.
Oh, yeah, bottom, though.
Well, the ball gives you armor when you get it.
Mm-hmm. So all right.
They're going to...
Makes sense. You're kind of defenseless. Oh, did he just pass it?
That was like clearing the zone.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. That's another thing you can do, right? I've seen someone throw it off the map.
Just to force a reset.
Force a reset. That's kind of cool.
That's right. Oh,
that's fine. He's in it for the game type. He's killing my KDR,
objectives,
but it's okay.
Objectives, baby. Objectives.
Yeah.
You guys ran right by that.
How much is left in this game? Near the end? What's the score?
17-10.
I think got this, right? They're up, right?
Yeah.
Chris is going to slam one home.
You got it.
Nail in the coffin.
Go! Throw it!
Shit!
Get up! Oh,
you son of a...
I was not watching the time.
Victory! Nice work. Congratulations. Well done.
Thanks.
Esports.
Field of victory vibes in my chest. Oh, yeah. If you guys are intrigued by Jeff's constant head shaking, CoreFX.com. Check it out.
4-17, Chris. You're killing.
Where are my points?
Look at the uplinks, though. He's got more than.
Look at how many uplinks.
They don't uplinks.
I have as many as the entire other team did.
They don't track uplinks in my one KDR.
Let's see it. Let's see what your KDR is.
I only have one.
Yeah, let's see how much I crept on it.
What's your?
It was going up. So see, it was going up. Wait, where's the graph? Wrong. You see the graph?
Yeah.
You see how the graph is just. Anyways.
You got 15 hours of this already. It's just out there a second ago. Nice work.
You don't need to see my Destiny hours.
Either. Uplink is fun.
Call of Duty: Advanced Warfare out today. Unless you got it yesterday. We better give away this Xbox One. To the gentleman or lady who won it.
Who is it, Danny?
There's a picture of a cat in here. I don't think that's who won it, Cynthia, though. That's pretty great, a picture of a cat. I like it. The winner is... Lunar Eclipse, ECLIPZ. Lunar Eclipse!
Eclipse,
you won yourself an Xbox One with Call of Dukes. Enjoy.
That's exciting.
And we'll see you on...
That is a good win.
It's a one terabyte hard drive in that thing.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Is that the $400 one?
That's
the
$400.
That costs the extra bucks.
Or whatever,
because
they knocked the 50 off, yeah.
Sweet. I'm going to get that bundle. Get that Sunset Overdrive bundle.
No, maybe. That's the white one.
That's the white one.
Yeah, I want that one. It's cheaper. I still don't have one.
That one's a good one.
And I've been cycling home with Xbox Ones.
You've been carrying Xbox Ones home?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's integral to the system. Without an Xbox One, without a Kinect, it's hardly an Xbox One. It's an Xbox None.
Oh.
You know?
I already have, like, 3 cameras on my television, and my room is such that it points at my bed.
Yep.
Sometimes I don't want that happening.
Why?
So I don't need a third thing that I need to move just in case. I'm like that dude on League of Legends who's picturing his pleasure
moments. Loco
Doco. Is that his guy's name?
Loco Doco.
Wow.
Esports player of the year.
Yeah. There you go.
There you go.
There you go.
Got him.
I like it. All right, we're done. Jeff, thank you very much for coming on.
Sweet. Yeah, no problem.
Tay, thank you very much. You need to go play Call of Duty for another 50 hours because we're not done with you yet.
Mm-hmm.
And Chris, thanks for coming back from that thing that's definitely under embargo.
It absolutely
which we
is.
We can't talk about, but you can talk about.
You know what else is under embargo? The Halo Master Chief Collection review.
When's that out?
Well, we're going to see.
Later this week?
We'll have something on Friday, at least a review in progress. It's tricky because the multiplayer servers are going to be up, but that's like 100-plus maps, and not going to be a ton of people playing, so like in terms of testing matchmaking and seeing what that whole experience is like, the full review might have to wait.
Yeah.
We'll
plus,
see.
Like the multiplayer portion of it is that 20-gig patch.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So it should be downloading now, but...
Until they post that... no one should review it, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So we'll have something up on Friday about it, maybe not the full review.
Sweet. Will won't be here. Me and Tay and Bauman, Giancarlo, and Justin Haywald are all heading down to Anaheim for BlizzCon.
Sweet. So we're going to shoot like 7 people to BlizzCon.
5.
BlizzCon.
Airbnb.
What?
Video games.
It is 10 years of...
Mike Morheim, it is. We're putting together a feature, 10 years of World of Warcraft. Right, so we're going to shoot a bunch of features.
Doing stuff there, sure. All right.
Yeah, so if you're going to BlizzCon and you think you have a story, we've still got a couple of slots open, please get in
story
touch.
About what?
Story about, it's. We're doing a bunch of stories about like how WoW has like individually like affected people's lives, for the positive and the negative.
You think there might be a few people at BlizzCon that have stories like that, do you?
Maybe one or two. Maybe some of them are watching this. Maybe not. But that's it for another week. Thank you very much. Thanks everyone in the back. Josh, Mary, Dan, everyone back there. Have I forgotten anyone? Nope, got them all. Thanks very much, Mary. Thanks for watching the show. We'll see you guys next week. Adios.